voice actress or singer, it's all together, and then that's Yui Makino. That's who I am. And then like what I do is being Yui Makino. That's what I am.
Anime and manga and J-pop, Japanese popular music, are considered elements of contemporary Japan, or what some academics call cool Japan. But we noticed in the video from Paris, Makino-san was wearing a very beautiful kimono on stage. How do you feel about the traditional elements of Japanese culture, such as kimono, ikebana, etc.?
そうですね、私は着物、お着物ももちろん好きなんですけれども、フランスの時に着ていた着物はフランスのモコナ先生に、セレクトしていただいて、モコナ先生のお着物をお借りして着てたんですね。で、そうですね、着物はちょっと自分で持っていたりとかはしないんですけれども、着物も好きだし、あとはお茶、茶道も、ちっちゃい時は、お菓子欲しさにですけど、よくお茶の教室に行ってました。
What actually did the kimono when I was wearing for, France Japan Expo, that was, I borrowed from Mokona Sensei, from Clamp, and actually that was Mokona Sensei's kimono. And then she picked that one for me too. And actually, I don't own any kimono, but I think it's the kimono culture is beautiful. And you know the sado, which is the tea, Japanese traditional tea culture. And it comes with a snack. It's a little snack. So I always wanted that one when I was little, and when I used to go to the school for that.
Well, we know that you like to sleep and that you take very good care of your voice, but I'm sure everyone here wants to know, do you ever sing karaoke or karaoke?
Yes, I go to karaoke.
What songs?
お友達と行くと必ず自分の曲は全力歌わされます。
When I go with my friends karaoke, my friends make me sing all the songs.
特にクランプさんと一緒にカラオケに遊びに行った時には先生セレクトの私の曲を長時間歌わされることが多いです。
When I go to karaoke with the clamp,they make me sing, and then they choose, they have special selection for me that I have to sing, and make me, like, they always make me sing my song.
Wow, karaoke night with Makino-san and Clam. Yeah. That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, it's a dream.
Alright, and finally, what major challenge would you like to confront or take on as a voice actress? What would be the peak project you'd like to do?
性別関係なくいろんな人ができるっていう。
I used to say, you know, I wanted to try, I want to challenge the kind of cold personality or strong character, and they gave me, the people gave me these characters this year, and I had a chance to try them. And then also some characters that like, it's really girly characters that I've never done before, but now it's people gave me the kind of roles and I could try, and it was nice. And then now maybe I would like to try maybe a boy character that I act a boy character. Maybe I would like to try that. And that's the best part of being a seiyuu, that you can perform as. It doesn't matter about female or male character, or even about the age differences. It doesn't matter, and you can perform whatever character you come in.
Wonderful, thank you. I'd like to give you a chance now to ask some questions directly of Makino-san while we have her here in New York. So please raise your hand, and I'll just ask you, since we do not have microphones in the audience, to speak loudly and clearly as you issue your question on the floor today. So, yes.
In 2007, you were invited to represent Japan at the Japan-China Cultural Exchange event, and I was curious what your favorite aspect of being a representative for Japan at such events was.
Okay, so I think the question was, in 2007, is that right?
Yes, in 2007.
Makino-san went to Shanghai to represent Japan at a cultural event, and what was your favorite part? Mm-hmm. About that experience representing Japan. Can you record the question?